Hi, I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British, and in this video we're going to touch base on serpentine belt replacement as part of our maintenance and repair academy for your 03 to 05 BMW engined Land Rover, full size, also referred to as the L322. Now in the kit you're going to receive both a primary and a secondary belt. Both are designed for your vehicle, and you'll find in this sheet that we have available on our website through the Maintenance and Repair Academy. This is downloadable and printable. It's Kit J, Belt Change Kit. Part number is PQS-000100-SKA. And you'll see listed both you receive a primary and a secondary belt. This is recommended every 90,000 miles. Remember, belts are a rubber-based component, and in fact, over time, they'll dry up, they crack, they shrink. You definitely don't want to be stuck on the side of the road with a broken belt. This is something that is definitely should be done on a regular basis. And then depending on the type of driving that you do, sometimes you may even want to check them on a more regular basis. They need to be changed maybe a little earlier. But under normal conditions, it's usually recommended every 90,000. So, these are the belts you receive with the kit, and in a minute we'll give you a rundown on how to replace those belts. All right, so we already have the engine cover off, which we've shown in other videos. It's just a matter of four screws, turn 90 degrees, remove the upper cover. And now basically it gives us access to our engine. First we're going to start off, we're going to take the snorkel off, which will give us room that when we take the fan and the shroud off, we have room to remove them. And that's nothing more than just a screw clamp on the throttle body. We just need to loosen that. Okay, then we have a line here, and you can see they actually put a there's a depress tab on here, and what you're going to essentially do is get a firm hold on the hose, push down on that little tab, and that'll release that. And then down below that, you got a small vacuum line. Yeah, be careful, because where it is, they have a tendency to dry out and get brittle. So I take a pair of new nose plier and get up to the front of that hose and then just snake it off there. Okay, then we're going to remove our mass airflow sensor connector. And our two clips. Be careful of the O-ring in here. Make sure your O-ring stays in place. Snorkel's popped off. We get that out of the way. Now you can see we've given ourselves some room to work here. Now, on the fan shroud, you've got a small module, a fan module, which is just to press the tab, wiggle and remove, and then your connector for your fans themselves. And that's two squeeze tabs on the top. Separate and release. And we'll tuck those out of the way so they don't get caught on anything while we're taking the fan and the shroud off. Okay. So we have two push pins right here that retain the top of the fan shroud. And we'll just take a pair of new nose pliers and lift that pin out of there. These little push pins basically are what locks it in place. All right, so now that we have the two push pins and the bases out, that releases the top of the fan shroud. Now we got to put it up in the air. We have a bottom panel and some more to take out so that we can access and take the fan and the shroud off. All right, so next step is going to need to remove this plastic splash pan down underneath. What we have is somewhere around 11 bolts run across the front. 2 to 4 on each side, depending on what model you have. Some are going to run just the 2 in the front, some are going to have 4, and then 2 in the back. We're going to drop this pan and reach up and unhook the heater hoses. All right, so now we have the shield down, and we're going to reach up, and we've got several areas where the hoses are clipped onto the fan shroud, and it's just a matter of really just popping them out of there. It's an open slot clip. You have 2 on the bottom, and up on the driver's side you're going to have a few. Now, again, you'd have another push pin normally right here. In this case, on this vehicle, it's already been removed, so we don't have to worry about that. And we're going to grab the bottom of the shroud just to make sure we got everything loose. All right, so now what we're going to do is back up top, remove the fan and the shroud assembly so that we have access to the belts. All right, so the next step is going to be to remove the fan and the fan shroud. To remove the fan, what you're going to need is a 32 millimeter extended fan wrench. We actually do list these on our website. You can purchase these either through us, because I doubt most local shops are not going to stock these. 32 millimeter, and then you're going to drop it on that looks like a large nut right on the back side of the fan. Now, take into account on these vehicles, this is going to be a left-hand thread. So to loosen it, you're going to go to the right. Now, we've already pre-loosened this nut. It'll come off relatively easy. You may need to break it loose. Sometimes just take the wrench and you can hit it with a heavy mallet or a rubber handle. I would suggest like a rubber mallet would work best. And once we crack it loose, they usually spin off relatively easy. And you can just simply spin it off, watching at which point when you're about ready to drop off. You want to give the fan some support. You don't want the fan banging into the back of the radiator. Obviously, you don't want to create a leak. You can grab the top of the fan and the shroud. We get about halfway up, and then these two locating tabs are going to hit up against the hoses. I usually pull the driver's side up first. And up and out. Okay, so now we've gained access to the belts. And you'll see the one drive belt here, and then the air conditioning belt in back behind it. So we need to remove the primary belt first. So now we got the fan and the shroud out of the way. We now have access to the belt. Now the design on these are a little different than what you may be used to on other vehicles that use a spring type tensioner. This one is a little more involved, so we'll go through all the steps on that. Before I do, just as a note, and you can use this as a reference, this is your belt routing for your primary belt. This is the large belt that we need to remove first. There is a secondary belt behind it. Now, if you'd like, and I usually recommend this, if you have a smartphone, you can take digital photos. I would suggest definitely take some pictures of your routing and basic locations of everything on your vehicle before you even take anything apart. It's a really good reference when you go to put everything back together. Okay, so we'll set that aside. And basically what you're going to need is a small screwdriver, a number 50 Torx drive bit. Now this one happens to be a security tip, but you can use a non-security, which that hole will not be there. 17 millimeter deep socket. Now the sockets I have here are all 3/8 drive. 13 millimeter deep socket with a short extension, a long handle 3/8 drive ratchet, and breaker bar 3/8 drive. So first step, we're going to take the 50, get that set up there, small screwdriver. On the front of the pulley, now these two pulleys right here are both part of the tensioner assembly, but one is an idler and one creates the tension. They have black plastic caps in the front that hide the center bolt. And on this top pulley, you're going to pop the plastic cap off with a small screwdriver, and there'll be your number 50 Torx that you're going to access and loosen. And you only need to loosen that maybe about one full turn. Put our cap over to the side here so we don't lose it. Do this with the breaker bar. And we go maybe one full turn here. Okay, that should be enough. Now, on the inside, we have a 3/8 13 millimeter bolt just above the top pulley. You'll see what looks like a shock absorber, small shock absorber to the left of it. This is your tightening bolt here. And then you actually have another bolt, 17 millimeter. And this is your pivot bolt. This is the one that you're going to put my tools on to turn and rotate the tensioner. All right, so then we're going to go to the pinch bolt, which is that 13 millimeter bolt behind the between the 17 millimeter and then what looks like a shock absorber. Now, when you loosen that, you should actually hear a snap. And what that'll be is that shock absorber, and I'm going to refer to it as that, but it's actually a tensioner. And what that will do is when you hear the snap, is actually going to move that tensioner assembly out of the way, so you'll loosen up the belt. So you'll now be able to slip the belt off. And you'll see, here's the condition of the belt we're taking off the vehicle. All the ribbing is starting to crack and split, which means this belt is drying out. And not quite at the point where it's going to fail, but it's definitely going to affect the performance. And then if we continue to leave it on the vehicle, it will eventually fail. So, now we have one more belt that's still in the back. It runs the air conditioning compressor right here. We have a tensioner here. And what I'm going to do is we'll show you how to remove that belt as well. All right, so we put the vehicle back up on the lift because it's easier to access the bolts for that back belt by the bottom side. And you'll see here, there's your pivot bolt. This is the bolt you're going to grab with your 17 millimeter socket. This is what you're going to use to turn this pivot so that it relieves the pressure off the belt. And then your pivot bolt, which is going to be up a little higher. And that's going to be your 13 millimeter. This is going to be 17. This is 13, and I believe in this case, I don't think we need to loosen that pulley. All right, so let's grab a 13s and start loosening. First, we'll loosen the pivot. All right, so we've loosened the pivot bolt, the slide bolt, and then your third bolt up here, which is where the pulley itself pivots on. You can put your breaker bar and your 17 millimeter socket on that, and you're just going to push in that direction, and you should be able to reach right up, take the belt right off that pulley. Now again, you'll see this is what happens when the cracking goes too far. You'll end up starting to lose chunks of the belt, and that's because of the dryness on the ribs. You'll start losing sections out of there because they get so dry and brittle. So this vehicle is definitely due for new belts. All right, so now we've got the lower belt or the compressor belt in place. And as you see, it wraps around the damper pulley, the tensioner pulley, and the AC compressor. Now before you tighten it up, you want to make sure that the belt is fully seated in the grooves and in its right position, both on the ribbed pulley here and on the ribs on the pulley on the AC compressor. Everything's set and square. What you do is the lock bolt, you're going to snug that in a little bit, and that'll just make it easier for you when you're ready to set your tension. Because what's going to happen is you'll pull this, now you're going to feel tension, and now what you're going to do is pull that forward, and what happens is that little shock absorber acts as the tensioner, and the pulley will float on that. Lock down your lock bolt. You want that good and snug. And what that'll do is that'll hold it in place while you lock down your pivot bolt and your upper bolt. All right, so now we're back down on the ground and we're ready to install our primary belt. You remember what we're dealing with? We have a diagram, or if you've got a smartphone, you've taken your pictures, and you're going to have your picture out in front of you. And you'll see essentially what you're going to do is you're going to start at the lower. This is your lower crank pulley. Your secondary air injection pump, alternator, your two idlers, and water pump. Alright, so now we have our belt in place, and you want to make sure that the belt is fully centered and seated on all the pulleys all the way around. Run your hand around all the pulleys that are ribbed, so you want to make sure that the belt is centered and in place. Now what we're going to do is we're going to tighten this up, and the pivot bolt, which was our lower bolt down the bottom here,
We've turned that in and have just barely snugged it up against the bracket. That's going to make it a little bit easier when we go to tighten things down. This bolt, this 17 millimeter, is in place, ready to set the tension up on that pulley. So again, just like the bottom, you'll pull it and you'll feel it get somewhat tight. You're going to give it a little pull until it's seated. Hold that in place. Get on the pivot bolt and give that a good snug. And that'll hold it in place while we tighten down the other two bolts that we had to loosen to do this. But you see you got good tension on there. And you don't have to worry about getting too tight or too loose on the tension. You're going to fully seat that pivot. I'm going to let that little tensioner, or looks like a miniature shock absorber, do its job. So now we're just going to tighten up the bolt on the pulley and tighten up the cap bolt on the tensioner pivot, the 17 millimeter, and we'll be ready to put the fan and the shroud back in. All right, now before we put our fan shroud back in, we want to make sure we put our plastic cap back on the face of the pulley. And what you can do at this point is, if you'd like, make sure everything is clear, make sure the hoses are out of the way. You can go inside, do a quick startup just to make sure that the belt is fully seated and that you don't have to loosen things again to put the belt back in place. It's a lot easier to do before you put the fan and shroud back in. You can run this for probably about 2 or 3 minutes without having to worry about any type of overheating or whatnot. So you're just going to start it, let it run for a couple seconds, and shut it right down. Take a look, make sure the belt is fully seated all the way around. The belts look good. Okay, now we're ready to put the fan and shroud in. All right. One thing I want to mention before I go sliding the shroud back in place, so that you'll be able to see this, will be a little more visible. You have a small clip right here built onto the side of the radiator. There's one identical to it on the other side right here. And you're going to have two tabs on each side of that fan shroud that need to slide into that groove underneath that clip, on top of getting into the two clips on the bottom. And what that does will center up the shroud so that it won't make any contact with the fan. So it's a little bit of doing, but just take your time, you'll get it in. And then once we set it in place, we're not going to tighten anything down. We're going to put this up in the air and then make sure that all our bottom sections are all in place where they should be before we go putting the push pins back in place. Okay, so we're going to put it back up in the air now. Alright, so we put the fan and the shroud in place. As I say, we haven't tightened anything down. We want to make sure the tabs from the bottom of the shroud are lined up with the slots in the bottom of the radiator. And then we're going to reconnect our hoses back into the retainers so that nothing gets caught up in the fan. Alright, there's three there. And then we have one way up here. Squeeze it together a little bit and it'll pop right into place. All right, so we're ready to put the splash panel back in place. Before we do, just to make sure that our fan shroud is in pretty good position, you can reach up and touch one of the fan blades, give the fan a little spin, make sure it doesn't feel like it's rubbing up against something. Okay, this one feels pretty free. I know I'm in my tabs on both sides of the fan shroud. I am lined up with my slots at the bottom of the radiator, so I believe we're good to go. All right, start a couple bolts just to hold this up in place, and then we can put the rest of the bolts in and snug them up. All right, we're going to double check. We're in our slots, sitting pretty firm, fan not hitting anything. So we're going to locate the hole at the top of the radiator for the little push pin, because sometimes it doesn't always line up exact. This feels pretty good. We'll push the base of the pin in first, because that needs to be fully seated. And now the outer pin, and this is what locks it all in place. Small little ball peen hammer, just something light. Lock that in. So with one in, the other one should be pretty close. Let's seat that. Pin. the wiring that we had pushed aside. Sneak that out from behind the AC. And we can probably sneak this back in behind the wire tie. There we go. Listen for that click. Set that back in and plug in your module. Give a little tug just to make sure your wiring is secure and it's not going to come loose. So all we need to do now at this point is put the snorkel back on and we're good to go. Alright, just a quick note. This is a left-hand thread on the fan. Even if you've left it loose a little bit, when you first start the vehicle up, it's actually going to turn opposite direction of rotation of the thread, so it's actually going to lock the fan in. If you feel a little more secure about actually having it locked in place, and take your 32 millimeter wrench, seat it, give it a little pop. That'll be more than enough to keep it on there. Alright, now before you put the snorkel on, you've got a rubber O-ring around the throttle body that the plastic snorkel seats against, and a rubber O-ring inside the opening for your air filter housing. Even just a little bit of oil buildup from your fingers and whatnot, just run your finger around both O-rings just to make sure, one, there's no dirt particles built up in there, nothing in the way that's going to create it from fully seating. Same thing with the big ring around the throttle body. And just give it a little rub down, get any dry dirt or whatnot that may have settled on there, get that out of place. It'll make putting it on a lot easier. So, we're going to set this in place. We're going to put the clamp pretty much in an area where we'll be able to get at it once we seat it up in place. We can work the snorkel back and forth. And we're fully seated. Pull the clamp up. Sneak the other end in. Your slots should line up with your clamps, so you can just clamp that end down. And always double check because it can unseat itself. Roll it back in. Okay, it feels like it's pretty snug. Give it a little wiggle just to make sure. So we're set at this side. We've got this clamped in place. We're going to plug our little vacuum line in back down the bottom. Your upper line. We'll wiggle in place, push down on the clip, seat it. Always pull back on it just to check because it doesn't always seat the first time. And you'll hear that pop. Now we're on. Here's your connection for your mass airflow sensor. Now, even though you didn't put a screwdriver on it, it's always good to double check the other clamp before you put everything back together. It's important that this is sealed anywhere past the mass airflow sensor. If you're pulling the air in, you can actually get a misread and it'll affect your engine performance. Alright, so last but not least, we can put our engine cover back on. You set it up in the approximate spot you knew it came off. You'll see your opening here around your oil fill cap. It kind of gives you an idea where you should be. You can see some of the bolts, you'll actually feel them set down in place when you give it a wiggle. We've got our 5mm swivel head Allen. You just need to turn about 90 degrees and you'll feel them locked down. Okay, and there you go. You've successfully installed both belts and you're ready for another 105,000 miles. So, when you're ready to change the belts over on your 03 to 05 full-size Range Rover, also known as the L322, give a call to any of our knowledgeable salesmen, 1-800-533-2210, and thanks for watching.